Hello, Aries. Welcome to another love reading. This one will be a bonus love reading where we're going to look at what's going on for you in love. What's the challenge? Who are you dealing with? What are they feeling towards you, towards the connection? And then we'll also look at their genuine intentions towards you, towards this connection. So let's start for Aries, Spirit, Angels, Guides. What does Aries need to know regarding love? What does Aries need to know regarding love, regarding this connection with this other individual? What's coming towards Aries in love? What's coming towards Aries in love? Death, Scorpio energy, some sort of change, some sort of transformation, maybe an ending. What's coming towards Aries? Scorpio energy as well. It could be a Scorpio coming towards you. What's coming towards Aries in love? Wow, the Lovers. Gemini energy. So there's a couple ways to interpret this. It could be that you literally have a Scorpio or a Gemini coming towards you. A partnership that is very strong with the Lovers. Maybe a soulmate. And this is a relationship that is born out of some sort of ending or change. Maybe you ended a particular cycle, Aries, or this person did. Can I know more, please, about death and the Lovers for Aries? This could also be that you ended a relationship as well. A relationship that maybe was a good relationship, but something has changed or ended here. So I want to get some clarity. What do we need to know about death and the Lovers for Aries? What do we need to know about these energies, Spirit? What do we need to know about these energies for Aries? The Chariot, Cancer energy. Well, that doesn't really clarify much because the Chariot is about movement towards something. So, for example, if you are in the boat that there is some sort of new relationship starting, or a relationship that has started out of an ending in a cycle or something like that, then you're moving forward in that relationship. If this is a relationship that is ending, then one of you is obviously moving forward. So let me be a little more specific and ask about death. Why is death here? Why is death here, Spirit? What do we need to know about this death energy? The Five of Wands. Okay. With the Four of Wands at the bottom of the deck. Okay. So again, I'm getting multiple messages here, Aries. I'm going to have to like narrow this down the more that I go into this connection into this reading, because I'm just not getting the clarity that I want to get for you. It's like the more I clarify, the more this goes in different directions. So the Five of Wands with death, I instantly think that a relationship ended due to some sort of conflict or drama, right? Like there was an argument that led to an ending, issues between you that led to an ending, right? And maybe this connection is over and you're ready to move on, or someone has left this connection, right? But then I have the Four of Wands at the bottom of the deck. So it could be that someone wants to come in with this Chariot after all of this has happened, right? Or it could be that someone wants to reconnect after an ending with you. Or it could be that you're ready to move on to something else now that this is over. I mean, there's just so many ways to interpret this. Cancer energy, Gemini energy, and Scorpio energy. I haven't said that already. So let's get some oracle cards here. And then I'm going to ask Spirit about the challenge for you. Spirit, tell me about what's going on for Aries in love. What do we need to know for Aries? Parting ways. Okay, so there is a separation here. I'm getting a little bit more clarity from Spirit now. A divide, a heartbreak, a separation. What's the energy for Aries regarding love? Unexpected event. So this is a Tower moment. So Aries, I feel like this could have happened in the past, but there's a separation here that's relevant. There is some sort of ending that's relevant to what's going on for you in love right now. So there could have been a Tower moment in a connection already. There could have been something that maybe ended that was very painful, especially with the Tower here. What else for Aries? What's the overall energy for Aries? What's the overall energy for Aries in love, Spirit? What's the overall energy for Aries in love? Enchantment, spellbound, captivated, delighted. I'm thinking about Spirit here. I'm not sure why. Almost like there's something here for you, despite the fact that all of this is kind of like burning up around you. Or someone could still be captivated by you after all of this has happened. That's another way to interpret this. What else do we need to know for Aries? What's the overall energy for Aries and love? Yeah, authority, recognition, achievement with the crown. Someone's admiring you despite everything that's happening. Like, there's still energy here of someone that's lingering, is what I'm seeing. So let's ask about the challenge. What's the challenge for Aries in love for the second half of... Okay. We have the Knight of Cups. Beautiful energy. What's the challenge? Now, this is in the challenge position. So it could be that there's something that you're not receiving, right? Instead of receiving a Knight of Cups, it hasn't arrived or it's delayed. The Two of Cups. Yeah, so I feel like maybe some of you have been waiting for an apology from someone. Or someone's trying to apologize, but this is challenged. And it's regarding some sort of special partner. I think it's the same partner because the Two of Cups is reminding me of the Lovers here. Yeah, Judgment and the Devil with the Moon. Now look at all this major arcana. Pisces energy, Capricorn energy here. When I say Judgment and the Devil, wow, two very powerful energies here. The Devil is a card about somewhere down the line, you were drawn to something by, you know, you were tempted or lured or attracted to something that didn't end very well. You ended up in some sort of unhealthy attachment or in an unhealthy environment. And Judgment is a card about looking back at all of your mistakes, looking back at all of the different journeys you've been through, and having some sort of realization about that, taking those lessons into the next chapter. So it's kind of difficult because the Knight of Cups is here. So with the Knight of Cups and Judgment, I instantly think of someone apologizing for a second chance. Maybe someone has realized their mistakes and it wants to apologize. That's one way to interpret this. Another way to interpret this is that this is a Capricorn, someone with Capricorn in their chart, coming in to ask you for a second chance as well. I think this is challenged though. I feel like someone, because this is in a challenge position, everything I just said is challenged. So someone might not be learning those lessons quickly enough. Someone might not have woken up yet. Maybe they haven't received enlightenment yet. Maybe they want to ask for a second chance with this Knight of Cups. I cannot talk throughout this reading. It's so frustrating. And Mercury retrograde is officially over, so I don't know what's going on. But when I see the Knight of Cups here with the Judgment card, it's almost like someone wanting to apologize, but this is in a challenge position. So someone's not able to apologize to you, or this is delayed for you. And I think it's because there's a lack of clarity here with the Moon, or there's some sort of illusion, or something that's not quite what it seems. Maybe there's some sort of fear or uncertainty that keeps someone from bringing this Knight of Cups to you. This is a very complex situation. And I feel like I'm like pulling teeth as I try to like figure out what's going on, Aries. Bear with me. Hopefully we get a little bit more insight now that we look at your person. Spirit, tell me more about this person that Aries is, has, or will be dealing with. How are they feeling towards Aries? What are their energies towards Aries? How is this person thinking or feeling when it comes to Aries? Page of Wands. So there's interest, initiative that someone wants to take. How are they feeling towards Aries? The King of Cups. So there's love here. There's emotions, feelings, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy. It could be dealing with a water sign. Eight of Pentacles. Okay, so I feel like this is somebody that wants to work things out, that still cares about you, still has feelings for you. tell me more about how this person is thinking or feeling about Aries. One more, just because I'm curious. Yeah, Four of Pentacles. So this person's holding on to you. They might also be holding back how they feel, but I'm getting holding on in that deck, in this card. And then there's the Magician at the bottom of the deck. So with the Magician and the Eight of Pentacles, I'm thinking, and the Page of Wands too, this person wants to take some sort of action towards you, some sort of initiative towards you. So now I'm wondering, what's the problem? Like, what's the obstacle here? Could it be that this relationship already ended? And that is an obstacle for this person, right? Like, they're like, I don't know if Aries is interested after everything that has happened, after this tower that happened in our connection. Does Aries, you know, want to even see me? What are their genuine intentions, Spirit, towards Aries? What are their genuine, like, what are their genuine intentions towards Aries? What are their genuine intentions? Seven of Wands. What are their genuine intentions? So I feel like they want to face this challenge head on. They want to fight this obstacle. King of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy. And the Eight of Cups. Wow, the Ace of Wands is here. So now I'm thinking, when I see the King of Pentacles and the Ace of Cups, does this person have responsibilities somewhere else? Are they busy fulfilling a responsibility somewhere else? Because that's the King of Pentacles for me. They tend to already kind of be responsible for others. And they're thinking about walking away with that Eight of Cups. Let me see. Let's get some PS I love yous here. What is this person thinking or feeling about Aries? The reason I say that they're walking away from something is because the Ace of Wands is at the bottom of the deck here. So if they are walking away from another situation, it's with the intent to have a new beginning with you, Aries. Or it's like they're being drawn or attracted to a new beginning with you. Now, the Seven of Wands is a card about fighting against any obstacle, challenge, or resistance. So you have courage to face every issue that presents itself to you. What do we need to know about this person's energies towards Aries? So this person could just be like willing to deal with what the problem is between you, right? Like whatever challenge between you, this person, yeah, I will make this right again. Yes. This one fell as well. You will always be in my heart. We get one more for what this person's thinking, feeling when it comes to Aries. Burdens and obligations. Yes. Someone that you are dealing with, Aries, I think that's the real problem. This separation could have happened a long time ago. This separation could have happened years ago or, you know, several months ago. Maybe this person got into another situation since then. Or maybe they have things to resolve in their own personal life that don't have anything to do with you, but are preventing them from coming forward to you. There's a lot of major arcanas here, which are telling me there's major shifts in energy happening here. I feel like this person is going to take some sort of action towards you because we have the Page of Wands and the Eight of Pentacles here. So it's someone that's willing to take some sort of, you know, initiative and make some sort of effort here with the Page of Wands and the Eight of Pentacles. And they're doing this because they've been holding on to you emotionally with the King of Cups and the Four of Pentacles here. And their intention, I feel, is to walk away from something. Eight of Cups, Seven of Wands, to fight for this, essentially. But the King of Pentacles, I instantly thought they have something else going on, burdens and obligations. So that's really the problem here. I feel like someone is still interested in you after a separation. And that's kind of what's unfolding right now. I feel like they maybe want to make a move towards you with the Chariot. But I think whatever happened here in this ending was very difficult with this Five of Wands and the Death card. It was not an easy ending. Otherwise, I'm going to leave it here, Aries. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this reading. If you did, don't hesitate to leave that like button. Like that like button. Subscribe if you haven't already. I really can't talk today, Aries. I don't know what's going on. and hopefully I'll see you on another reading very soon. Take care.